Hello everyone, this is Chanaka. Welcome back to my YouTube lecture. So today's topic is on mode 1 programming in timers. So as you know, there are 4 types of modes: mode 0, mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. So how we are going to select these modes? So using M1 and M0 bit of DMOD register. So when you put 00 in M1 and M0, you are going to select mode 0. When you put 01, mode 1, 10 mode 2 and 11 mode 3. So I told mode 0, which is of 13 bit timer, so that's why you are not going to use in 8051, which is of 8 bit. So where mode 1 is a 16 bit timer mode, so you are going to use this mode in 8051, and even mode 2 you are going to use because it is a 8 bit auto reload, so where you can use both TH and TL register. And mode 3 is for split timer, so there is a split in TH and TL, so that's why you are not going to use mode 3. So usually we are going to use mode 1 and mode 2. So now we'll see in detail the entire structure of mode 1 and mode 2 programming. So here, mode 1, you can see here below, this is a block diagram of mode 1 programming. So first unit here, it is XTL oscillator, then divided by 12, then AND gate, then TH and TL values, then TF. Okay, so here, so you know C bar T, so when C bar T is equal to 0 means it is going to do timer operation, when C bar T is equal to 1 means it is going to do counter operation. Okay, so that's why if C bar T is equal to 0, it is used as a timer for time delay generation, and the clock source for the time delay is the crystal frequency of 8051. Okay, when you are using C bar T is equal to 0, it is going to used as a timer for time delay generation. So you have to give input to start the timer. So the input is the clock source for the time delay is a crystal frequency of 8051. So here you can see XTAL is the crystal frequency of 8051. You are giving as a clock source as an input to C bar T to start the timer. So here the crystal frequency, it will not die directly. So that crystal frequency, first you have to divide it by 1/12, okay, so that you will get the timer frequency. Okay, any crystal frequency, it is going to be divided by 12, then you are going to get a new frequency, that is nothing but timer frequency, and using that timer frequency you are going to start the timer. Okay, so here you can see it is a 16 bit timer, so timer 0 and timer 1 both are 16 bit timer, so therefore you have to load the values, that values must be in terms of 16 bit. Okay, so before starting the TR, so TR is a timer mode, so it is used to start the timer. Okay, so here to before starting the timer, you have to load the TH and TL value. So TH is a higher byte of the timer, TL is the lower byte of the timer. Suppose you are using timer 0, so it is a TH 0 and this is a TL 0. You are using timer 1, it is a TH 1 and this is a TL 1. So before when you start the timer, you have to load the initial count in this TH and TL, where TH is going to have 8 bit data and TL is going to have 8 bit data. So entire data will be 16 bit. Okay, so initial value usually we take from 000 to FFF. So final value is always FFFF. So initial value, it is left to you whether you can use 000 as the initial value, or in the range of 000 to FFF you can use as an initial value, and the final value will always be FFFF, and these values always it will be in terms of hex value. Okay, so here you can see first point, it is a 16 bit timer, therefore it allows value of 000 to FFFH. So this is a range where you are going to load the values, initial values in TH and TL of this mode 1 programming. Okay, so usually we say it is from 000 to FFF, so it is left to you what type of initial count you are going to use. You can load 000, it will count up to FFF. If you take FFF2 as the initial value, it will count up to FFFF. Okay, so this is to be loaded in the timer register TL and TH. Okay, so first TL value is loaded and then TH value is loaded, so entire value will be of 16 bit. After loading TH and TL, okay, so which is of 16 bit initial value, the timer must be started. Okay, so using TR you have to start the timer. Okay, so I told in the previous slide how to start the timer and how to stop the timer. okay. So there is a gate bit in the TMOD register where you can start the timer and the stop the timer either by software or hardware. So leave hardware. So now how to start the timer by software? That you have to make that bit as zero, means gate bit in the TMOD register you have to make zero, so you can stop the and start the timer by software. So when you're using in terms of software to start the timer, I told you have to use a instruction called setb. So here you can see the cursor, setb, so it is for start the timer, and clr is to stop the timer. Suppose you are using timer 0, the instruction will be setb tr 0, okay. If it is a timer 1, the instruction is setb tr 1. So these two are used to start the timers. So now after when timer is started, it start count up. So whatever the initial value you loaded in TH and TL, it start counting up to FFFF. Okay. So till then the TF flag. So there is a one more register called TF, that is timer flag. So again you are using timer 0 means it is denoted as TF 0. You are using timer 1 means it is denoted as TF 1. Okay. So this is used to indicate whether the value is overflow or not. So whatever the initial value loaded, it start counting when you start the timer from 0. Suppose assume that the initial value is 0000. When you start the timer by using this software instruction, then it will start from 000, 001, 2, 3, so on up to FFF. All values are in terms of hex. Okay. So till it reaches to FFF, TF flag will be 0. Okay. So now when TF flag becomes 1, then we must assume that the overflow is going to be happen, means it is happened. Okay. So it is overflow or rolls over from FFF to 0. So that time when you find TF is equal to 1, that time you have to stop the timer. Okay. So what's the instruction you are going to use to stop the timer is CLR TR 0 or CLR TR 1. So here you are giving a input as a clock here. So I told when C bar T is equal to 0, it is used as a timer for time delay generation. The clock source for the time delay is the crystal frequency of 8051. So whatever the frequency, that frequency will be divided by 12. Okay. And you are going to get the timer frequency. Using this timer frequency, the timer is going to be work. So before that you have to decide whether you want it in terms of timer programming or counter programming. So if C bar T is equal to 0, it is going to select as a timer for time delay. If it is a C bar T is equal to 1, it is for event counting. So now I made C bar T is equal to 0 because I want to write the timer program. Then I am giving input as a timer frequency. So here there is a TR to start the timer. Before starting the timer, you have to load the initial value in TH and TL. So initial value is, it must be a 16 bit because the timer is of 16 bit. So you can load initial value, is left to you, but the range you have to follow, that is from 0000 to FFFF. So you can load initial value as 000 or in between the range of 00 to FF, but the final count will be FFFF. So once you loaded the initial value, you have to start. Okay. So start is again depending upon the hardware or software. Suppose you used hardware, you have to give external input. If you are using software, by using these instructions, you can start the timer. So suppose you are using timer 0, you have to use set bit B TR 0. You are using timer 1, set bit B TR 1. Okay. So once you start the timer, the initial value is going to be start counting up, and when it rolls over, TF flag will be 0. Once it overflow, the TF flag becomes 1. So you have to go on monitoring whether TF flag is 1 or 0. So once the TF flag becomes 1, you have to stop the timer. So how to stop the timer? By using the instruction called CLR TR 0 or CLR TR 1. So here you can see when it rolls over from FF to 00, directly it rolls over from final count to the initial count, that is FF to 00. It sets high a flag bit called timer flag. Okay. okay. So each timer has its own timer flag, means you have, for using timer 0, the timer flag will be TF0, and if you are using timer 1, timer flag will be TF1. So same timer flag will not be used for two different timers. For each timer it has own timer flag, okay. So here, while counting, the timer flag has to be monitored, can be monitored, okay. So when the timer flag is raised, means it becomes 1 option would be to stop the timer with the instruction called CLR TR0. Suppose you are using timer 0, you have to stop when TF is equal to 1 by using this instruction, that is CLR TR0 or CLR TR1, okay. So after the timer reaches its limit and rolls over, in order to repeat the process, okay, when the timer is stopped, again you want to repeat the same process, counting the for numbers or counting the initial value to maximum value. So that time what you have to do, TH and TL must be reloaded. Again you have to reload the values in TH and TL with the original value, okay. And then TF must be also reloaded, because when you reload, if you leave TF equal to 1, then it will not count. So once you want to start again from the starting, or you want to start the count with new value, so you have to reload the original value in TH and TL. Along with that, you have to load the TF also.